Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we're going to be talking about the brand new Red Dead Online update that just happened, all the new content, the discounts, bonuses, sales, and a whole lot more. So believe it or not, Red Dead Online has been getting a lot of new content over the last couple of weeks. Rockstar have saved a good bit of this for the tunables and for the weekly drip feed sessions that we're getting right now, and that's the sort of thing that they're introducing. And I'm even going to be covering last week's, as I got so tied up with the casino update in GTA Online that I completely forgot that Red Dead Online even got an update too. So the first thing that Rockstar added today is a new showdown mode called Sport of Kings. So Rockstar says battle on horseback to secure the burning torch and ride through all your team's signal fires to score in Sport of Kings. The newest Red Dead Online Showdown mode is a true test of horsemanship for two teams and 4 to 8 players. With sawed-off shotguns for close-range combat and rare single-shot dynamite bow pickups on either side of the torch to even help the odds. So overall, this sounds like a really fun showdown mode. It kind of sounds like a race and a mixture of capture the flag. So it's a fun and interesting concept, that's for sure. So if you want to play that, that is the latest showdown mode to be added in Red Dead Online. Now, after that, Rockstar have added some new clothing additions. So the first thing they added today is the Strung Sombrero, which is pretty cool. I thought there was already a sombrero in the game, but I guess this one's a little bit of a different style. It's personally not my look, but if you're creating a Western gunslinger attire, then that's something that you can ultimately do. Rockstar also added the Gibson pants too, which is interesting. It features hand-cut leather paneling and cross-stitch sides, perfect for the town or trail, as Rockstar puts it. And then they said they introduced an all-black variant of the Chuparosa poncho. So this is actually awesome. I love the poncho. You see my character wearing it in-game. And they finally added an all-black version. You can very faintly still see the pattern on there, but from a distance, it would just look like it's all black. So those are the new clothing items that Rockstar decided to add this week. Last week, as I said, I missed it because I was focused on the GTA Online update or the rumors of the new update. Rockstar added the Belrose hat, which looks awesome. It's this fancy-ish style hat with like a big feather coming out the side. And what's interesting is Red Dead Online players who signed on last week are going to receive a unique tent of the Belrose hat for free. So that's pretty awesome. Rockstar also added new Flores vest designs and limited supplies of the Calhoun boots, raccoon hat, and Schaefer chaps. So that's all the new clothing that Rockstar decided to add. Also, last week, Rockstar added another event, another showdown mode. This one is called Public Enemy. So Rockstar says, in this world, there are only two ways to win. Either be the public enemy or be the one to bring them down. In this new showdown mode, each team has a designated public enemy, which rotates regularly amongst players. Kill the opposing team's public enemy to score points, but be careful. Every kill they make is a point to the other side. So this kind of sounds like a Wild Wild West version of Protect the President, where you've got like one VIP on the team, and that's the one that you want to protect, and that's also the one that they want to kill. So again, sounds like an interesting mode. What's nice about the showdown modes is you can play them as often as you want and whenever you want, because you can just select it from the menu. The next thing we're going to be talking about is a little bit more random, and that is a free roam event. Now, it's a cool one, don't get me wrong, but Rockstar added the Railroad Baron free roam event. So what you have to do is ride the rails and capture as many train cars as you can in this traveling variation on King of the Castle. So you have to accept the invite to begin and fight to keep control of the active area on the train car for the longest amount of time over the course of the event to claim victory. So this one sounds like a lot of fun. It involves a vehicle, which is kind of unique. But the problem with these free roam events is they pop up so infrequently, and there's not even a chance that you'll get the brand new one. You might get an old one that was available on day one. So that's the problem with those free roam events. I never seem to get the ones that are brand new, and then I get frustrated from waiting. So those are the new modes and events to catch you up to speed and what Rockstar has added. Now, also, Rockstar handing out a lot of nice bonuses over the next 2 weeks. They said, and for the next 2 weeks, all players who are at least ranked 10, which should be most of you guys by now, will receive a care package featuring bait and special arrows like the poison arrow, a powerful weapon in taking down large game that is normally crafted using arrows, feathers, and oleander after the acquisition of a poison arrow pamphlet. And players who are at least ranked 20 will get an additional package that includes provisions and big game meats like the minty big game meat that is normally cooked after acquiring mint and big game meat and gives you a gold health core. And to help you hit those rank bonus thresholds, you can take advantage of 30% XP boost on all activities this week. So to give you some more details on the care packages, the rank 10 bonus care package will have 20 small game arrows, 20 fire arrows, 20 poison arrows, 5 predator bait, and 5 herbivore bait. So again, good stuff right there. The rank 21, in my opinion, is a lot better. So I would try to get to rank 20 if you're not. You get 3 minty big game meat, 3 oregano big game meat, 3 thyme big game meat, 10 baked beans, 10 corned beef, 10 canned salmon, 5 Jolly Jacks, 5 cocaine gum, 5 moonshines, 5 gins, 5 guarma rums, and 5 fine brandies. So I don't know why Rockstar are going out of their way to provide bonuses at such a low rank. To me, what I think this indicates actually could be a hint towards the next DLC. Typically, when Rockstar are trying to promote or push something revolving rank, it's usually because in the next update, there's going to be like a rank requirement in order to do something. And we know the next update is going to be featured around role-playing. So I wonder if like the role-playing choices or the ability to start some of that stuff might be a higher rank, like 10 or 20 and above, which isn't all that hard to get to. Now, I'm not the highest rank in the world because I've only sporadically been playing Red Dead Online when new updates have come about and such. It's not something I typically do on the daily, but it's pretty easy if you use a conservative effort to get to rank 10 or 20. And especially with the XP bonuses that are going on this week, 30% more, that's a lot. So you should actually be able to rank up fairly quickly compared to normal weeks where there might not be such a bonus available. Now, I'm sure you guys are going to be wondering, well, what would be the best activity to take advantage of the XP boost? In my personal opinion, Showdown Series, which is great because there's 2 new ones that have been recently added, and using special ammo. So if you use special ammo to kill or hunt, you're going to get XP for that. And what's kind of neat about that is the Lamat Revolver, the newest weapon that was added. If you use the shotgun variant of that, that will count as special ammo. So just something to keep in mind right there. Those are some easy ways to sort of rank up in Red Dead Online, especially this week with the XP bonus. And the last thing we're going to be talking about in this video today, I went back to the original Newswire post when Rockstar first released this DLC, and it looks like this might be the final tunables update that they do for Red Dead Online. Because as you can see here, the last thing they mention is June 11th's update, which will include the Sportive King Showdown mode, limited time and permanent clothing additions to the Wheeler Rawson catalog, and more. And after that, they don't mention anything. So I think that over the next 2 weeks, because they mentioned, you know, for the next 2 weeks, you can get the care packages and whatnot, that will be it. And as I mentioned earlier, I think a good portion of the next 2 weeks is Rockstar encouraging you to rank up so that you can start to prepare for the next Red Dead Online update, which again is going to have like a role play aspect to it where you'll choose the life of a bounty hunter, a trader, a collector. Who knows what other roles will come along with that. But it would be cool if we got some more information on that soon. I don't know how soon that will be because it looks like Rockstar's focus might be shifting to Grand Theft Auto Online very shortly with the introduction of the casino. So as always, I'll be sure to keep you guys in the loop, but I think that's going to be everything as far as what we're seeing in Red Dead Online, at least for a bit and until that summer update arrives. And keep in mind, summer lasts until like September. So there's a good chance we might not see this update for a good bit. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully you did enjoy. If you did, be sure to leave a like rating on this video. That'd be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.